North India with MaxLife. I welcome you all on behalf of MaxLife. And today's webinar is conceptualized keeping in mind the requirements of fellow Indians like you all who are staying abroad. And this webinar is divided into three sections. The first is introduction of MaxLife. Second, why investing in India is a great opportunity for NRIs and OCIs. What are the available tools? What are the benefits and the tax implications? The third section will be question and answers round that we will take it at the end. So please feel free to put your questions on the chat box and we will take it at the end. So let me introduce today's speaker. So we have Mr. Dinesh Mantri, who is a qualified chartered accountant and he is heading NRI business with MaxLife. And he has an experience of more than 17 years in insurance industry and expertise in NRI business. So with this, I welcome you all once again. And I welcome Dinesh. So over to you, Dinesh. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Archana. Just let me know if you're able to hear me.
Yes, yes. Here, we can hear you and we can see the screen also.
Thank you, Archana. Thank you for the confirmation. And namaskar, everyone. Good evening to all our guests from New Zealand and Australia. Afternoon for Australia. And other parts of the world, eastern part of the world, is good morning, everyone. And a very good morning to our distributors in India. Thank you so much. I appreciate you have taken out time during the weekend. In your family time, you have taken out time for 60 minutes. And I assure you that in this next 60 to 70 minutes time that you are going to invest here, you will be able to get some value addition. And that's the endeavor which we want to accomplish during this webinar. So let me begin this webinar by first of all, as I mentioned, inviting you. And first section which I would like to take is the introduction of our company, a small introduction, just in brief, so that we know what we are, which company we represent and what is that company all about. We represent MaxLife Insurance, which is a joint venture between Max Financial Services and Mitsui Sumitomo Company. Max Financial Services is a listed company in India, and it is the India's largest non-bank and private life insurance company. Max Financial Services owns and actively manages 72.1% stake in MaxLife. On the other hand, the other partner of this company is Mitsui Sumitomo Insurance, which is a general insurance company and world's leading general insurance company. It is headquarters in Tokyo. It is present in 39 markets and experience of over 120 years in general insurance. The vision of this insurance company is to be the most admired life insurance company by securing the financial futures of our customers. And when we say word admired, we mean to say that whenever a person wants to invest in a life insurance company, our endeavor is, our vision is that the first company they should have in their mind is Max Life Insurance. All our acts, all our work it towards accomplishing this vision. Just on a number front, let me share with you a little brief about this company. We are a 19-year-old company and this is our 20th year of operation. We are headquarters at Gurgaon, near New Delhi. We have around 300 plus offices in India. However, in current situation, we are digitally present everywhere for our customers in India and outside India. We have around 14,000 employees and 60,000 agents. And we manage assets worth 68,471 crores as of 31st of March 2020. We are ranked 24th in India's Great Place to Work, and this includes every kind of organization. And in all life insurance companies, this is number one. Why it is important is because happy employees will always look at a very good customer service, and that's what our vision is. On a death claim settlement ratio, which is the most important parameter to judge a life insurance company, we are number one in the country. And we settled 99.22% last year in financial year 2019-20. On terms of how many how much money do we manage for in on behalf of our customers? I mentioned 68,470 crores, and we are among the top 10 best fund managers in the country. We have insurance coverage which we have given to our 40 lakh customers is around 9 lakh crore rupees. So that's a brief about what company and its credentials. It is a financial, very financially stable company, and a company to be relied upon. Let me share with you how our asset under management, which we are managing on behalf of our customers, has grown. And this is nothing but the trust which we manage on behalf of our customers. And you can see how this trust is growing year on year in last 10 years time. We have not shown the first 10 years because they were small. We started in year 2000, but in last 10 years you can see how this has grown. Last slide on Max Life brief is about how do we repay the money to our customers. As a life insurance company, we repay in two ways. One is maturity claim at the time of living and at the time of death. So these two events we do pay money to our clients. So now in last financial year, we paid one maturity claim every 8th minute. That's a financial strength of the company to repay. So by the time when we have have 8 minutes in this webinar, right now, we would have done one maturity claim to one of our clients. In an unfortunate event of death, which we insure, we pay one death claim in every 30 minutes. If you look at last 5 years, our death claim settlement ratio has grown from 96% to now 99.22%, which is India's best death claim paid performance. We have one more important thing for our clients, very, very important. It's called as Insta Claim. Death claim payment in just one single day. The day, if the life insurance is for 3 years and death happens after 3 years and up to 1 crore of insurance value, and if we get the documents, let's say by 3 p.m. of the day, the same day the claim is processed in favor of the nominee. And in case of any event, for whatever reason, we are not able to pay, then we will pay a daily interest on that value. That's a commitment which has been given by the company, and that's as I mentioned, the one work towards becoming the most admired life insurance company. So that's a little brief about the company which we represent. Now I'm going to the second section about non-resident Indians. All of you are living abroad in different countries, some of our guests has also joined from US, the West Coast. I know it's late evening there, and really thank you for us. Thank you from our side for being there on the webinar. India has been receiving a lot of money from their non-resident individuals. This is not just this year or last year or few years. It's been the number one country in receiving remittances from abroad from individuals for last 30 long years, since 1980, and never ever India came second. And that's what you also do. I'm sure most of you would have remitted some amount of money to India for various reasons, maybe to send money to their parents or send money to their to your relatives or for investment purposes. So different reasons, but India is been receiving the highest amount of remittances across the globe. Now, why India receives a lot of money? Now, India receives a lot of money because of various reasons. India receives money because of number one thing is because of the country is growing at a very good rate. I understand in current situation, in pandemic situation, almost all the economies are suffering. Almost all the economies are degrowing except China. China also very small percentage of growth. But if you look at last financial year and before that, India was the fastest growing economy in the world. And according to the GDP predictions by IMF, International Monetary Fund, they project that India again will be the most fastest growing economy in the world. So that's the reason a lot of corporations, high value corporations, large value corporations and companies are investing a lot of money in India. Many sovereign funds of Singapore, and many other countries for that matter, Saudi and many PE funds from the US, everyone is investing money in India. In last 1.5 years, 18 months time, India has received the highest amount of remittances from foreign companies. So you name the top 10 companies of the world, they have invested in last 1.5 years time. So be it Amazon, Facebook, Google, Walmart, I can just name it, and they have invested money. Apple, for that matter, a lot of companies have started coming into India. The reason why they have coming to India is because the potential of the market is very big, and the kind of returns they get from India is very high. Also, diversification is very important thing, and the reason why these companies have invested money in India. So that's the first thing why people are investing money in India from foreign countries. Now let me come to individuals. You and me are individuals. Individuals invest in different parts of in different asset classes. Companies invest in businesses, but as an individual, we invest in asset classes like equity, metals, real estate, and some of the guaranteed products like bonds and other things. Now, equity, different asset classes are of different types, and they have different features. They come with different risk, they come with different returns. Equity gives you very high return, but it comes with high risk. It has a good amount of liquidity. Gold and silver are also very good investment because they are good hedge against inflation and also against equity prices if they are falling, or against the economy if they are not doing well. Its prices are subject to market conditions. You can look at in last few months what has happened to gold and silver. The prices have gone up and also came down. So a lot of things has happened, and it is a very high liquid kind of asset. So it's a good asset. Now, third is real estate. I mean, a lot of people invest in real estate for getting rental income and also appreciation of value over time. However, it gives you it gives you money for long term, but it comes with the maintenance cost. It comes with ownership cost, your property taxes and other money for maintenance. You have to pay for it, but it has no liquidity, very less liquidity in case of emergency requirement. But this is a very good asset class because it gives you rental income for very, very long period. And the fourth asset class is guaranteed products, which include bonds, life insurance, and product like those, and bank deposits. It gives you a safe and secure return. It gives you guarantee of money. But it gives you lower return than other asset classes. So as an individual, always as a financial planner, as a good financial planning, as a prudent financial investor, appropriate asset allocation is a must for each individual and family. So can we put all the money in gold, silver? Yes, we can. But is it good? I don't, many financial planners believe that it is not good. All the money in real estate, all the money in guaranteed products, all the money in equity, I don't think so. That's a good strategy or a prudent strategy for investment. The best way is to invest in all four asset classes, and it also depends on the kind of age you are. So if you are higher age, more money should be in guaranteed products. If you are at a lower age, more money should be equity. So it depends on the kind of income you and amount of money you invest in. So if you have $100,000 to invest and you are investing just $1,000, I'm sure you can take risk on that. But if you are out of $100,000, if you are investing $50,000, then you may take risk, you may not take risk. So you need to adjust that according to the risk. So depends on amount of investment and the age which you are in. So now let me come to the point why people from abroad are investing money in India. Equity, when it comes to equity market, India has been the front runner in terms of the returns on equity which stock market is giving. For a better representation, we have shown different equity markets of the world for a longer period. We have not compared 5 years, 7 years, 10 years, because 5 years, 7 years, 10 years is a very short period. And in this short period, it is not good to do a comparison because equity was always in bull run during this time. We have compared 15 years and 20 years of all the equity market, the big equity market of the globe, which is against the equity market of the of of India, which is Bombay Stock Exchange. Now, Bombay Stock Exchange in 2005, it was 6,226 points. And if we have compared with UK, US, New York Stock Exchange, Dow Jones, S&P 100 of US, Nikkei of Japan, Hang Seng of Hong Kong, and Straits Times of Singapore. We have many other large equity market of the globe. However, because of the space constraint, we have not shared this, but we do have comparison with all other equity market. You look at the rate of return which equity market of India has given against other equity market of the world. 13% is the rate of return approximate, which is given by equity market of India. And this is just an equity index. It is not a mutual fund. It is not a product. It is an index comparison, because that's a data which is available readily. And that's the data which is available in the stock market. Against 3% to around 6.5% of different markets of the globe. In 20 years, equity market of India has given around 11% against 0.5% to 4.5% of the market. I'm sure if you would have invested in some mutual funds or products like those, you would have got much higher return than what is mentioned here. Definitely those products are available which beat the benchmarks. We are not talking about those products in comparison, because in India also we have many products like those which beats the equity benchmark. But this is just a comparison between different markets. Now, that's the reason you could look at it, the reason of why non-resident Indians are investing in Indian equity market, or not all the money, but definitely some part of their money they invest in Indian equity market, because of the kind of return which equity gives you. The second asset class which we mentioned about gold and silver, the gold and silver gives you almost same returns everywhere, because it is a global market. It's just the currency fluctuation which may differ during the price calculation. However, the returns are almost similar wherever you invest. If you invest in real estate is very, very different asset class. As I mentioned, it depends on which city you are investing in, which country you are investing, which place you are investing in, what kind of property you are investing in. Are you investing in a land? Are you investing in a apartment? Are you investing in a house? It depends on that and the kind and the place where you invest. So there is no index to compare which market gives you what return. Now, if you look at the fourth, which is guaranteed products. Guaranteed products, a lot of people do invest in guaranteed products in this current situation also, because this gives you safety of money, as I mentioned, and security of the capital. During current times and in near future times, we have seen that most of the market of the globe, the interest rates have come down drastically. In the US, it is now 0.20, depending on different bonds available, different bank deposits available, ranges from 0% also to almost 1.1%, depending on different kind of bonds available. In UK, in New Zealand, in Singapore, Australia, I'm sure you know about it better than me because you live there. So if these markets give you very low return. In India also, the rate of return in guaranteed products have come down. However, still, the rate of return is approximately 6%, which is very, very higher or very, very high in comparison to all other markets. That's the reason a lot of individuals from abroad are investing money. In fact, bank deposits and life insurance, life insurance remittances to Max Life also has grown by 100% in last two quarters. So the reason is absolutely because of the equity market and because of the interest rates, which are very, very high in comparison to other countries. So that's an overview of how people are investing and why people are investing from abroad. Let me now go to the product section, which is the kind of products in which non-resident individuals are investing in. And a lot of resident individuals who are high net worth, they are investing in these products. I would like to start with a story, and a very small story, which is, which will help us understand how this product works in a better way, in a simpler way. This is a story of my third child. And this story says that, this is a story of a couple, and it's a couple of Mr. and Mrs. Ram who has two children, and it's a complete family. And Mr. and Mrs. Ram, they work very hard and spend most of their earnings for their children's education. And understand, in most of the countries, children education is free by the state, but we do spend a lot of money on their extracurricular activities, on their work, on their day-to-day learning. So this couple also spend most of their earnings on their children education, and they met an advisor. The advisor asked few questions to this couple, and that, and you can ask questions to yourself if you have come across the advisor. Don't you think it is time that you have to start saving for your retirement? So this couple says, I'm sure your answer also will be the same. I want to save. However, the cost of inflation is so very high, and we are left with very little to save. The second question which the advisor asks is, if you're not planning for your retirement now, Mr. Ram, would you be okay? And this very important question, if you're not planning for your retirement now, would you be okay to ask your children for your household expenses once you retire? I'm sure your answer would be same what this couple has answered. How can I ask? I'm 100% sure that I won't be comfortable asking for it. Mr. Ram, if you had one more child, would you have given the child also the same level of education which you are giving to other two children? I'm sure your answer also be the same. Yes, I would have, 100%. So Mr. Ram, how much money do you spend on your annual fee as annual fees on your two children? And this is just a representation of annual fees. It could be, money spent on their upbringing, their swimming classes, their guitar classes, and different kind of extracurricular activities which we do for our children. So this is an example that I spend around 500,000 rupees in a year on my two children. You can think about this, the money which you spend on your two children. So this is another important point which the advisor says, Mr. Ram, now I'm asking you to adopt one more child. And you fund this third child also with the same level of fees which you are paying for your other two children. And Mr. Ram, this third child, I don't know about your other two children, your first two children, but this third child has only one responsibility. That is to take care of you and Mrs. Ram in your presence and in your absence as well. So Mr. Ram, this third child has only one responsibility, to take care of you and Mrs. Ram in your retired life, in your presence, in your absence. And this third child is your retirement plan. Your retirement plan has to be as if you have to fund your retirement plan as if it is your third child. And you have to spend the same amount of money which you are spending for your other two children or one child if you have, so that it takes care of you and your spouse. Now, this is an example of a product which we give and suggest to our non-resident clients and high net worth individuals of India. This is called a smart wealth plan, and this has many versions. The version which people look at here is a long-term income benefit option. And this is just an example. This is a representation. There are multiple options available. Permutation combination can happen depending on your current situation and your requirement. This is an example of Mr. Agrim, who is 40 years old and he wants to plan for his retired life. He wants to save some money every year. He does not have money all immediately, but he wants to save money every year since he is working. And he wants to save money for next 10 years time, and he invests 500,000 rupees. In Australian dollar terms, you can say around 10,000 Australian dollar, maybe 10,000 Singapore dollar, approximately kind of thing. Now, he invests money for 10 years, which means he invested 5 million rupees, approximately 100,000 Australian dollar, approximately 100,000 Singapore dollar, or 100,000 Canadian dollars. American dollar will be a little lesser. This is just an example. After the payment term is over, after the 10 years is over, there will be a break of 1 year, and from the 12th year onwards, for next 25 long years, Mr. Agrim is going to get 4.73 lakhs, approximately, 4.7 lakh of money every year for next 25 years. And at the end of 25th year, the entire investment which we have done of 5 million rupees or 50 lakh rupees will be given to him as a terminal benefit, guaranteed. All this money is guaranteed. All this money is completely guaranteed. There is no, in a simple words, irrespective of the change in the interest rates in the market, I'm sure you would agree with me that in last so many years, the interest rates have gone down in every country, including India and including all other countries for that matter. Irrespective of that change, this interest rates is guaranteed. There is no change in the amount of money which you are going to get, which Mr. Agrim is going to get. There are other options available. As I mentioned, this is 10 years payment. There is another option of 6 years payment for people who are little higher age. And permutation combinations are available in this product. But I want to assure you that this product is a very, very unique product, which no other company, no other instrument can give you. Many instrument gives you the rate of return on your today's investment. But we give guarantee on your future investment as well. And therefore, this product, a lot of people look at. This has got life insurance coverage as well for first 11 years time till the payment term is over. So it means that in case of an unfortunate event of death, God forbid, if death happens, then the family should not be suffering, because the spouse needs money even after the death of the husband. So we will give an immediate lump sum value, which is 10 times of the value which Mr. Agrim was paying in a year. So the entire 10 years payment, which was supposed to be done by Mr. Agrim, we will pay a lump sum to the family. In fact, 11 times, so that, you know, so that's the amount of money of life insurance coverage which we give to our clients. Now, this is another product of which I wanted to mention about retirement. And this is again a 1 minute story which will help us understand how this product works. This is a story of a person who retired at the age of 50, 20 years back in year 2000. And he invested 1 crore in a fixed deposit or a bank deposit at that time. Now you can take an example of a bond, maybe annuities at that time, or products like bank deposit at that time. In India, if he would have retired at age 50 in year 2000, he would have invested in bank deposit. Now bank deposit are good, very good products, because they give guarantee, they give rate of return which is safe and secured also. At that time, he would have got 12% rate of return. Now the point is, usually bank deposits are for 3 years, 5 years, maybe 1.5 years. The maximum tenure of a bond, of a bank deposit, is, which people take, is around 10 years. The problem is, after the year 2000, he would have got 12% every year. However, he would have renewed this fixed deposit in year 2010. Right now, in 2010, the actual rate of interest on a fixed deposit in India reduced from 12% to 10%. Now, therefore, this individual would have actually got 10% rate of return for since the year 2010 for next 10 years time. Again, in year 2020, he would have to renew this fixed deposit. And in current situation, fixed deposits in India, the bank deposits or products like those, bonds, everywhere, the rate of return is approximately 5.5% to 5.7%, depending on different bank, maybe 6%. And again, this product will be for 10 more years. In year 2030, I don't know what would be the rate of return during that, at that time. Nobody can predict, but looks like the trend really shows that the rate of interest is going to go down. It may go to 2, it may go to 3, it may go to 3.5, I don't know. But it looks like it is not going to be stable at 5.7. Now, in this situation, the summary is fixed deposit or bonds returns are decreasing year on year. The rate of return of fixed deposit and bonds in your country would have been different. But I'm sure you will agree the rate has been decreasing over years. In year 2000, in the US, the bank deposits used to give around 5%. Now, today, they are giving 0.2, 0.6%. The rate of interest is going down. Same is the case in Australia. Long time back, in year 2000, Australia used to get 7.5%, and today it is 1.5%. So definitely the rate of interest is going down. However, on the other side, the cost of the inflation, the cost of living is increasing, and we have represented by Indian Thali. I'm sure in India or wherever you live, you would have gone out and you would have made your own Thali. And this is just a cost of representation. And this is just a representation of the cost of living. In year 2000 in India, a thali would have cost 20 rupees. Same thali now in 2010 would have cost 50. Same thali today, it is cost around 150. Keeping that trend in mind, maybe after 10 years, this cost would have been 300. The summary is cost of living is increasing year by year. So entire summary is the returns from a fixed deposit or a bond or a bank deposit is decreasing, but the expenses are increasing, which means that if we trust only fixed deposit, we would not be able to help in our retired life. Let me share with you how life post retirement is. And I am not retired yet. I have no experience about retirement. However, we have spoken to many individuals who have retired, and this is as per our experience, which they have shared with us. The experience is that life post retirement comes with many challenges. It's good to be retired, but you need to maintain lifestyle. Nobody wants to reduce the lifestyle. And we want to fulfill the dreams which we were not able to do when we were working. Maybe going on vacation may not be in current situation, but definitely after pandemic is over, we would definitely like to go somewhere with our spouse, with our children, and spend time. We also have to protect our health. I understand a lot of people may say, oh, I have a health insurance. I understand health insurance is there, but it does not cover everything. The cost of health goes up every year since as our age increases, and there are co-pays in our health insurance year on year which increases. So therefore we need to have money for protecting our health. And lastly, some people say that we want to leave a legacy to our next generation. Now all these needs, all these requirements post retirement needs a guaranteed fixed income, and fixed income should be for lifetime. If we trust our bank deposits and product like those which gives guaranteed returns, the rate of return is decreasing, and the expenses keeps on increasing. So therefore we need a product which gives guaranteed income. So we have a product called Guaranteed Lifetime Income Plan to cater to this requirement of our clients in India and abroad. This product name is Guaranteed Lifetime Income Plan. And as the name suggests, it gives you guaranteed income. It is a lifelong income, lifetime income. And I've explained lifetime income means. It also helps people plan their retirement early. And it also helps people give legacy to the next generation. And it can also cover spouse after retirement. And it has complete flexibility. I would like to explain this product in a very simple example. For us to understand this. This is an example of Mr. Sangwan. Sorry if there is someone who is Mr. Sangwan here. This is just a representation. If your name is same, it's just a coincidence. So this is an example of Mr. Sangwan, who is age 50, and he has some money available because he saved some money during his work life, and he wants to plan his retirement early. Now he has around 1 crore of money available for his retirement in current situation. In currently, he has got this money. If you're age 40, maybe 35, you will not have some amount of money as a lump sum. You will have to save some money. So the product which we mentioned last time was the right product. This product is for those people who are age 45, 50, who has earned money over years and saved some money for them. So this person wants to invest one crore of money into a retirement product, and he wants a guaranteed income. How this works is he invested 1 crore investment as a lump sum from at age of 50. When he turns age 60 at the time of retirement, he will start get 11,27,100 rupees guaranteed every year on year till he lives, till his lifetime. And I mean to say my word lifetime. Lifetime means till he lives, maybe till age 85, 95, 100, 120, 150 years. That doesn't matter. The number of years he is going to live, he is going to get the same amount of income every year on year, irrespective of the change in the interest rates in the market. Irrespective of the change in the interest rate, he is going to get the same amount of money. So 11,27,100 rupees, and you can understand, you can calculate very easily how much is the rate of return which we are giving on this product. The day when Mr. Sangwan is no more, and his spouse is also living at that time, his spouse also requires an income for her life till she lives, to protect her dignity, to have her income, to live. So therefore, we will give the same level of income to her till she lives. Same 11,27,100 rupees, not even 1 rupee less, not even 1 rupee more. Exactly same value we are going to give to her till she lives. I'm sure you will agree, females live longer. If you look at your society among the old age people, you will find more females than males. So they live longer and they require money for their livelihood. So therefore, we will give this same income to her till she lives. The day when she is no more, we give the entire money which Mr. Sangwan paid to their children, and we will add 5% value to that as a loyalty addition. And we give 1.5 crore rupees to the children as a legacy. So this product helps people plan their retirement early from age 50, 45. And we give and book a guarantee rate of annuity for their lifetime, and that's how this product works. Now, who buys this product? People who are age bracket between 45 to maybe 65, 75. Those age group people, invest in this product. Number one. Number two, people who are younger, definitely they also invest, but not for themselves. They invest for their parents. So if you have your parents back in India and you want to send them some money every year, every month, that's okay, that's absolutely good. But if you you invest in your country, maybe Australia, New Zealand, or whichever country you live in, the rate of interest on your investment is very less. You can look at this rate of interest. If you send money from abroad to this product for your parents, then your parents will get this income every year till they live, and after that we will send, after their death, whenever it happens, we will pay you the entire lump sum which you paid back to your country where you live. Or if you want us to pay in Indian rupees, we can pay you in Indian rupees as per your choice. So a lot of people who are in younger age bracket who have parents also in India, they also invest for their parents there. So these are the two scenarios where people from abroad, they invest in. This is the second product which I mentioned. The last product today in today's webinar, we have multiple products, but the last product which I wanted to mention is another variant of Smart Wealth Plan, which I mentioned the first time. It is a product which gives you guaranteed income. Now, let me share with you some of the milestones which we work for. If you work for our child's higher education, children marriage, or maybe just for our savings purpose, for any investment purposes, we invest some part of the money in some part of our money in guaranteed products. And that's, as I mentioned in the second part of the webinar, as a prudent investor, some part of the money should be invested in guaranteed products, which gives you safety of money, security of money, and guarantee rate of returns. Maybe equity gives you very high return. However, equity comes with risk. So to manage the risk, investing in guaranteed products is a better option as an added advantage. Now, we have a product in which you save money every year, and you save money every year. Now, if you invest in fixed deposit or products like bonds and products like kind of a mutual fund which is in debt portion, now what happens is they give guaranteed products, definitely they give guaranteed returns, but the challenge is same. The rate of interest will be guaranteed on your today's investment only. So if I go to a bank and I say I want to invest 500,000 rupees, 5 lakh rupees, and in a product like fixed deposit or a product like that bond, they will tell me, okay, Mr. Dinesh, this is the kind of rate of return I am going to give. Let's say 6%. But when I ask them on the same time that next year in 2021 also I am going to invest 500,000 rupees, what is the interest rate you are going to give me on that 500,000? I'm sure you will agree with me, the banker or anyone who is selling this will say, sir, whatever the interest rate at that time, that will be applicable on your next year investment. The problem is today's investment, I'll get a guaranteed rate of interest, but next year investment, the rate of interest is not guaranteed. It may change. And you have looked at the trend, it is decreasing. So therefore, the challenge is they are good products, but they does not guarantee rate of return on my future investment. Our goals are guaranteed. Child education, if you want to give some money for your child's higher education, give some money for the at the time of their marriage or for just an investment purpose, the rate of interest is not guaranteed. Here is a product which we want, which we give to our non-resident clients and our high net worth clients, and we give guaranteed rate of interest not only on your today's investment but also on your future investment. The same rate of interest what we are giving today, it will be applicable on your future investment as well. So this is an example of Mr. Ravi. He is investing money for 8 long years. He is investing 8 years, let's say 1 million rupees, 10 lakh rupees he is investing every year for 8 years. Now he wants money for his child's education, higher education, and after age 6, after 16 years he wants money. So at the age of after 16 years we will give a guaranteed amount of money, 1 crore 60 lakhs. So overall he paid 80 lakhs or 8 million rupees, and we give 16 million rupees guaranteed, irrespective of the change in the interest rate. And it means that today when Mr. Ravi is investing in the first year, his first installment of 1 million rupees, we will tell Mr. Ravi that this is the rate of money on your total investment, this is what we are going to give. Which clearly means that not only this interest rate is guaranteed on your first year investment, but same rate of interest is applicable on second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, every year when you're investing, the same rate of interest keeps on coming. The interest rates range between 5.5% to 6.2% depending on different age group and number of years. There are multiple permutation options, combination can happen. Maybe you want to pay for 5 years short period, maybe you want to invest for 12 years, you want to take money in 15th year, you want to take money in 12th year, you want to make it in 20 years. As per your requirement you can choose when you want to have money. So this is a product which lot of individuals look at when they invest money in guaranteed products. This is a much better product because it gives not only today's investment, same rate of interest is on future investment. Lastly, it has a life insurance coverage also, which helps individual in planning his life insurance as an added benefit for his family. So I don't have to tell why life insurance. All of you are educated, you know about life insurance. It helps definitely family, and therefore it is important for our financial planning. So these are some products which we have. Lastly, I want to talk about various permutation combinations of different other products. These are not the only products which we have. We have multiple other products. Some are equity based product also. A lot of individuals from abroad, they invest in equity based products because they want to participate in India's growth story, and they don't want a small or a, less rate of return. So for them, we have equity based products. There are some dividend based products as well, which are also gives you a non-guaranteed or semi-guaranteed product, and they are fully guaranteed products. So there are different products available. So my recommendation to all of you is, we have not covered everything here because of lack of time. We want to recommend you that you should, if you are looking for these kind of products and investing in India and want to know about it, maybe you do not want to invest but want to know about it, then my recommendation is to discuss with your advisor, block your 40 to 45 minutes next week or this weekend, maybe tomorrow, and you can block the time of the advisor who has invited, he or she can share and understand your needs and requirements and can share the right product which is good for you. Also, I would like to share in last 2 minutes time about the kind of proposition which we give to our non-resident clients, and this is specific to our non-resident clients. Non-resident clients require a lot of other benefits, extraordinary benefits than resident clients because they live abroad. So we are unique in terms of giving some benefits, and this is very important slide. As I mentioned, we want to be the most admired life insurance company, and all these things are towards accomplishing that goal. We say that we understand non-resident are not live in India, and therefore he or she can buy while he is in his own country of residence. So if you're in Australia, you don't have to come to India to buy a life insurance or invest money with us. Or if you are in India, you can invest. So both options are available for you. It's very hassle-free documentation. Everything is digital. And you don't have to send document by courier or by a post. Everything is by email or WhatsApp. Third, you can pay money in your own currency. So if you are earning in Australian dollars, you can send in Australian dollars. If you are sending money in Japanese yen, you can. If you are sending money in Hong Kong dollar, Singapore dollar, as per your choice. Or if you want to send money or invest money in Indian rupee from your Indian account, all these options are available. So if you are sending money from Australia, you can use Combank, you can use Orbit, either of that, whichever payment options you want to choose, you can, or transfer by either of that. So that's the third, which we, the benefit which we give to our non-resident clients. Fourth, and the very, very important thing, specifically to NRIs who want to settle abroad only and do not want to come back to India, or OCIs who already settled abroad. This is a very, very important point, which nobody in India gives you. Now, if you send money in your currency, if you send money in your currency, then you can get money, you know, in your own currency or in Indian rupees as per your choice. And I explain you in detail about it. So let's say you earn in Australian dollar and you are sending money in Australian dollar. Now, at the time of remittance, at the time of paying you back, every investment in India requires you to have an Indian bank account. You have to have an Indian bank account. Your redemption will always come in Indian bank account. Many a times you may not have an Indian bank account, or your Indian bank account is dormant, or whatever may be the reason you don't want to get the money in Indian bank account. You want money to be in, paid in Australian dollars. We will send you all the remittances in your Australian bank account or in any other currency, whichever currency you want us to send in. So if you are sending money in US dollars and you want us to send, pay you back, maybe your child, for your child education, child has gone to Australia. You know, you have paid in US dollar and you want us to pay in Australian dollar. We will send you in Australian dollar. As per your choice, we can do that. And this choice need not to be done today. You can do this choice at the time of redemption only. You can choose to change it, or you could choose to you know, change it to Indian rupee also, as per your choice. Lastly, maybe this is an important thing for you. If you buy anything from India, not just life insurance, if let's say you are living in Canada and you know, you are buying something from India, you have to pay goods and service tax. In your country, it could be called as sales tax or value-added tax, VAT. In India, it is now called as GST. In your country also, it may be GST. In Australia, it is GST. So, in India, if you are buying, if I buy something in India and I have to pay GST, but you are a non-resident, you do not live in India. If you are not living in India, then, and you are paying from your NRE account or in your own currency, maybe Australian dollar, foreign currency, which means, then you don't have to pay goods and service tax. So the goods and service tax, which levied on life insurance, also is exempted. We exempt it. You know, you, whenever you want to buy something, let's say you want to buy you know, an item from India, you can ask the shopkeeper, you know, that I don't want to pay the goods and service tax. This is my passport. This is my copy of passport. This is my residence proof of New Zealand, and the money is come from you know, NRE account. So don't pay, you know, don't charge me GST. And he can do that. He may choose to not to do that also. It depends on the seller, but the law says, yes, it is possible. So we give this benefit to our non-resident clients, and we do not charge goods and service tax. So that's another benefit which we give. Lastly, everything with us is digital. Be it customer service, be it by investment, be it you want to understand anything about Max Life, everything is digital by email, by you can contact us via portal. There's a customer portal which will give you ID, password. You can send us WhatsApp messages. You can send us an email. You can send us various ways of communication. Maybe the old you know, way of talking, that is also available if you want to choose that also. So all those mediums we have for our clients, which are digital, to talk to us. So that's the customer service which we give, and that is what I am trying to tell you. So last point, as I again mentioned, please take out your time. It will be advisable if you just discuss with your advisor for 40 minutes. I think it would be worthwhile for your time to understand what are the products available with Max Life for you. So thank you so much. Thank you everyone for attending this workshop and this webinar. Archana, if there are any questions, I'm happy to take those questions.
Okay, thank you so much, Dinesh. Yes, there are a few questions. So there's first question is, my prospect is technically an overseas citizen of India. Does the plan still work? If I do not have an Indian passport, if I do not have any Indian residence proof, but I am a person of Indian origin and I carry a foreign passport, so can I buy it? Am I eligible?
Sure. That's a good question. If you are a foreign citizen, you are no longer an Indian citizen, you do not hold an Indian passport, you are an overseas citizen of India, OCI card. So OCIs are those people whose either themselves they were from India earlier, or their parents, their grandparents, or their great-grandparents in four generations. If any one of your parent or grandparent or grand or great-grandparent were from India or undivided India before independence, you are eligible for overseas citizen of India card. If you have a overseas citizen of India card, even if you don't have, but you have a proof that you have India's relationship and roots, then you are eligible. India's OCI law says that if you are an OCI, you can do everything what an Indian citizen can do. It's a quasi citizenship given by India, by the way. You can do everything what I can do. I am an Indian citizen living in India. I can do everything in India as per law of India. You can do all those things which I can do, except for two things. You can't vote in elections and you can't buy a new agricultural land in your name. Except for these two things, you can do everything. So you can invest with Max Life very easily. You do not have to give your Indian address proof, no requirement of Indian Aadhaar card, PAN card or something like those. Everything will be of your own country, your passport, your address proof, and you can send money in your currency. Let's say you are from Japan and you want to invest with us, you've got Japanese citizenship, you send money in Japanese yen and we can send you back in your Japanese account or whichever currency you want us to pay. You may not have an Indian bank account, that doesn't matter.
Yeah, thank you, Dinesh. So this is a person who is 60. What are the options for him whose son is NRI and can pay his premium? So you just mentioned, if you can just reiterate.
Surely. So at age 60, there are multiple options available. As I mentioned, you can invest in your son's or maybe grandson's name if you want to give a legacy to them. Or if you want to invest for yourself, for your own retirement, definitely that option is also available. And there are multiple other products available with us. May I suggest you, it will be advisable to take out 40 minutes, 45 minutes of your valuable time and discuss with our advisor, and our NRI expert also will be a part of this discussion. In this, we will understand what is your need and then suggest you the right solution, which is good for you. And you can take the decision to invest or not to as per your choice.
Yeah, thank you, Dinesh. So a very important question, will the policy also be issued in USD like FCNR deposit or INR?
Okay, I understand your question. If you are from US, I'm sure this question will arise to you about this question. And we get this question from the US many a times, and not just many times, every time. And most of our clients are from US, by the way. Even after currency fluctuations come in picture. So this insurance policy is denominated in Indian rupee. It is denominated in Indian rupee. You can send in US dollar. This US dollar will be converted to Indian rupee and then invested in this policy. At the time of maturity, it will be given in Indian rupees. But if you want us to send in US dollar, we will convert that in money into US dollar and send you back. And therefore, currency fluctuation will come in picture in this kind of product. However, even after currency fluctuation, this product could be a better choice as I mentioned, diversification from the US investment to India. Many of our clients say that, and they are right, they are not wrong, absolutely right, that Indian rupee devalues. And when it devalues, I lose a lot of money. Now, when you invest in US dollar, and that converts into Indian rupees, devaluation comes in picture. However, when we share this answer, I was expecting this question, and therefore I have a slide here in front of you. So we have done a lot of work and understanding of how US dollar and Indian rupee has moved over years, and you know, it's not made by me, but we have understood by many investors who invest in India. You know, we have many Americans, or by the way, many other companies and corporations who invest in India. And I have been fortunate to talk to one of the big investor, and I asked him, then multiple of them also, I asked, why do you invest in India when Indian rupee is devalued? And they have shared this calculation. They told, actually, Dinesh, we understand that Indian rupee is devalued and we have to give back money in US dollar. But diversification is one very important point. And this has more so now after pandemic has happened. They say that how much devaluation can impact me? I first of all find out that. And what is my option available? If I don't want to devalue my currency, I will invest in US. What money I will get, what return I will get from US in comparison to what I get in India, and remove the taxes and remove the devaluation of money. So if I remove that, whether I get more money in India, if I get, it makes sense for me to invest. If it does not give me that kind of return which I get in US, then it does not make any sense. So that's a fair evaluation. They say, don't look at 1 year, 2 year, 5 year, 5 months devaluation. It is not right way of doing it, because currency fluctuates too much in some time and very less in some time. To get the right picture of how much devaluation is, look at a little longer period. Therefore, you will find a trend line. You may get in short term some evaluation, some devaluation. So for example, in year 2006, Indian rupee appreciated. By the way, in last 6 months, Indian rupee depreciated too much. But if you look at last 2 months, Indian rupee appreciated too much. So that also, you know, sometimes it happens. So therefore, a longer duration calculation will help us understand the trend line. If you look at 20-year horizon, in year 2000, the Indian rupee was approximately 43, 44, 42, that kind of range. And in year 2020, that now is 76. Now it is 73, by the way, but we have taken a calculation of 76. Now, if you do a CAGR calculator, just put a CAGR calculator online and put this value 743 to start with, 76 at the end, and it took 20 years, you will find 2.8% is the rate of depreciation. Now, in a life insurance, and this 2.8 is a point-to-point calculation. I invested in year 2000, I got money, everything in 2020, and that's a deposition. But in life insurance, you do not invest in lump sum. You invest sometime some money today, same amount of money next year, third year, fourth year, fifth year, eighth year, tenth year, like that. So you put money in staggered way, and therefore you will invest less amount of dollars every year, because if the depreciation is there of Indian rupee. So today, if it is 75, you will send $10,000 for 7.5 lakh rupees. But next year, if the Indian rupee depreciates, then you will send less amount of money. So therefore, you will do an averaging of this value. So depreciation is not 2.8%, it is 2.3% if you calculate it for 10 years. Now, if you invest money in debt market, which is guaranteed product in the US, what is the rate of return you get? Today you may get 0.1, 0.6, maybe 1%, maybe 1%, either of, you know, the kind of bonds you invest in. Minus you have to pay the tax in the US as per your slab rate. There's no depreciation. So how much you will get? 0.7% to 0.07 to 0.70, depending on the kind of product you are. In India, you get 6%. Minus the tax which you pay in the US, it is a slab rate. It is the federal tax is at the base level, which is 10%. You pay 10% tax, and minus 2.3% of depreciation, you still get 3%. Now, if you compare this, definitely it makes sense for me if I would be investing my money, and I will be unbiased in that. There is no biasness whether I invest in US, I invest in India. Unbiasedly, I see, oh, there is a good difference. Same is the case in equity. So therefore, some part of my money, maybe, you know, $10,000, $15,000, something, or maybe $8,000, whatever value you want to save, you should invest from a diversification and much higher rate of it. So that's the answer, little long answer, but I think that was required.
Yeah, thank you, Dinesh. And if you could give some overview on tax implications, maybe for Australia, Hong Kong, Singapore, because the timings is, you know,
For
for
sure.
those times.
Yeah, I understand. I understand. So good. Your questions are valid. There are tax implications. Let me tell you, as an individual investor, you have to look at two countries' taxation. Now, first country is India, where you invest. Second country is where you get the money. Now, in India, life insurance proceeds are completely tax exempt. So if you invest in life insurance, I also invest in life insurance, or you also invest in life insurance in India, they are completely exempted from tax. Not the long-term annuity, lifelong income, that's not. However, the products which I mentioned, the Smart Wealth Plan and product like equity, they are completely exempted from tax. The lifelong income, that is taxable, it's an annuity product. Now, look at your own country, where you get the money. Depends on your country what the tax laws are. Let me share with you a few tax laws. Now, if you look at New Zealand says, lump sum value if you receive from a life insurance policy investing in India, you don't have to pay any tax. So my request to all people who are from New Zealand, do not invest in monthly income product. You invest in a lump sum product. You pay money every year and you get a lump sum. Because monthly income is taxable in New Zealand. Australia, it says that if you have invested for 10 long years, means if your policy, maybe your premium is only for, your payment is only for 5 years, 10 years, 7 years, that doesn't matter. If your returns are, if the total policy term is more than 10 years' time, then all the policy proceeds are tax exempted in Australia. If it is less than 10 years, then standard deduction of 30% will be applicable. And 70% gains will be added to your taxable income, and you will be taxed at for your slab. If you're in Japan, it's completely exempted. Hong Kong, completely exempted. Singapore, completely exempted. In Thailand, completely exempted. And many countries I forgot the name, but these are the countries from where we get most of our business from. Most of our clients from these countries, and therefore I remember this. If you need any clarification on maybe other countries, we do have clarification of all the countries, the tax laws. So that's about taxation impact.
Yeah,
So
thank you,
therefore, if you
Dinesh.
are living in Australia, invest in a long-term product, 10 years or more, your income is tax-free.
That's great. So there's one more question on product. Investment of 10 lakh at age 35 for 15 years till age 50 will amount to 1.5 crore. Receiving 1.6 crore at age 51 is not much. I don't know which product he's referring to. Am I missing some detail? So Dinesh,
So I understand. So you are saying at the age of 35, you are investing 1 million rupees, 110 lakh rupees for 15 years. You will save 1.5 crores. You see 1. No. No product will give you this rate of return. I think what we wanted to mention was you invested 10 lakh for 8 years. That was the example given at age 35. You invest 10 lakhs for 8 years, which means you invested 80 lakhs. After 16 years, you will get 1.6 crores. So that was the kind of, and the rate of return approximately will be around 6.01, 6.5.9, that kind of range, rate of return is on that one. And we can share with you in detail if you really are interested in looking at this calculation. We can share with you little more details about this.
yeah, sure. In fact, I would suggest you to have a meeting with the person who has invited you, and you can have everything, and he will share with you in black and white. Maybe you're just talking about some other product, and maybe a long-term guaranteed product you're talking about. And a few questions on product, a lot of questions. If I'm not able to continue my premium after 3-4 years, what will happen to my policy?
I understand. I think it's a good and important question.
Yes.
The answer is we understand. The situations may not remain same for a long period. And this pandemic has helped us understand more detail about it, that the situation cannot remain same year after year, every year. So our products are also flexible to actually cater to this requirement. So our products are flexible enough that let's say you are not able to pay for any years, then can you stop paying and can you continue afterwards? So that option is also available. You do not want to pay at all after some number of years if your financial condition does not changes, and you do not want to pay at all after a few years. That is also option available. If you want to withdraw money in between, that option is also available. If you want to, and different conditions can happen. You want to give this money to a next generation during this policy tenure. You want to give this to someone else. Not someone else means in your family members, that's also option available. So all those things are available, flexibilities are available with our products. And therefore, we cater, we understand this requirement and we give this benefit to our clients. Over to you, Archana.
Yeah, thank you, Dinesh. And I think we have taken most of the questions.
There is one more question about OCI card. Will OCI card be sufficient or any more questions? No. So OCI card is good enough. We'll definitely require your passport copy and OCI card definitely is there. So in USD,
One important question from UK. I work in Department of Rail and Road in the UK. What will be my tax implication of on repatriation to UK in case of lump sum?
Surely. So UK, I think, is very early morning, sir. Thank you so much for joining in. I really appreciate you have taken out time. UK law says that the insurance income, whether you invest in India or whether you invest in UK, that is a gain. That is a gain. It is taxable income. Now, is it then after paying tax, is it making sense for you to invest in India? Yes, because you get higher rate of return in India. In UK, you get an X amount of return. In India, you get multiple of that. So paying tax is one aspect. Tax is always on income. Higher the income, higher the tax. So if I say for myself, I can take this liberty of, because I am able to unmute myself, if my organization gives me more salary, if my organization increases my income, I have to pay more tax. Will I deny my income? Answer is no. I will always say, good, thank you. Please give me more income. I am ready to pay more tax. Because tax is on my gains. Higher the gains, higher the tax. If I get more gains, it makes sense for me to take that money. If I don't get the gains after paying tax, then I don't have them. So we can share with you exact details about how this works in UK and US. All countries presentations, dedicated countries presentations we have, and therefore my request to you is please book a time and we will share with you in more details.
Okay, so Dinesh again from UK, what would be my net return be post-tax on repatriation? If you could just give an approximate idea, like we gave it for
you. So if the product is a guaranteed product, which means 6% is the rate of return, the kind of, I don't know what's your tax bracket, it can be 20, it can be 40, it can be 45. There are three tax brackets in the UK. If you're at 40% tax bracket, 6 minus 40%. And if you're 20% tax bracket, 6 minus 20%. It's a gain added to your slab. So that's the kind of tax which you have to pay and the net gain you will get from. If you're investing in equity product, equity gives you higher rate of return. It comes with risk, but there is a higher return for longer tenure, and therefore the rate of return will be much higher in equity product. But it depends on how much risk you want to take. So different products, different combinations are available.
And different currency fluctuation is also there. So I would appreciate if all of you from different, you are from different countries. So you can take a meeting with the person who has invited you along with the NRI expert, and you'll be able to understand that what is the net return after tax implication and after currency fluctuation. So
there's one more question. Last question. I think I will take it's planning is majorly for people who are younger age. My request is not that. We have many clients who are OCIs, many, many thousands of our clients who are OCIs. They're never going to come back to India. Their children are never going to come back to India. We have many clients whose children has never come to India. in their lifetime. They don't have a bank account in India. No future what will happen, but we actually have many clients who are OCIs and they are settled abroad only. So these plans are actually for everyone, for resident Indians as well, for non-resident Indians as well, and for OCIs as well. So therefore, my request is again, I think if you can take out some time, this webinar would be not be possible for us to share with us in detail, but individually we can discuss with you and share with you how does it helps you, and then decision is yours.
Yeah. So there's another question from US tax implication. I think Dinesh had already addressed that question. So again, a lot of generic questions are there. I mean, we have been able to address most of the questions, but questions related to product, what product should be there, that I would suggest, like, once you will have a personalized meeting with the person who has invited you, and you will share, what kind of financial goals you have, financial liabilities you have, and what is your risk appetite, we would be able to suggest you a better product according to your requirement. So that's it from our side. So thank you so much for joining in, and thank you again. So that's it for the day.
Thank you everyone. Namaskar. I appreciate you have taken out time during your weekend. I appreciate you have taken out time for people in the US and Canada in the late evening of Friday, and UK. Really appreciate you have taken out time early morning, and people from Australia, from New Zealand and Japan, Hong Kong, Singapore, Indonesia, Malaysia. Really appreciate you have taken out time during your day, in your weekend time. Thank you so much, and appreciate. Thank you once again. Namaskar.